Amanda, how are you?
Hey, Rocco, how are you?
Come on in.
You never call.
Oh. Ken, speaking of great chefs, what's going on, Ken?
Hey, Rocco, what's up, man? How are you?
Nice to see you.
How's everything?
Everything's good.
Hey, excellent. How are you? Nice How's to everything? See you.
Christopher, what's going on? Thank you so much for coming. Are you hungry?
Oh, I'm hungry.
Frank, come on in. Ready for your first dinner party?
Yeah.
Union Jack.
Oh, my goodness.
I like that chandelier. That is beautiful.
This is awesome.
I'm loving the fireplace.
Wow, that is gorgeous.
Oh, I'm over here.
Oh, I love the spikes.
It's very Sid Vicious, oh. Isn't it?
What's up? It's Lana. Love it.
Would you like a match set, Chris?
I want to make bacon-flavored chips, so what's the most effective and tastiest way to do it? And to me, that was using molecular gastronomy, whipping out some of my tapioca maltodextrin and powdering some bacon fat and mixing chili and salt into it.
So there's one person that doesn't eat pork, so that's a malt, vinegar, and salt. This is ready to go.
I love that fireplace. Frank, is that hard to get a fireplace like that, or where do you go?
Come down to my showroom. We'll sort you right out.
I love Frank. He's a good man, my new friend.
Ooh. Ooh, potato chips, I like it.
So on this chef's menu, for track one, obviously there's a music theme, bacon chili crisps.
I love the chips, by the way. I'm a big fan of the chips.
We're seeing some molecular gastronomy already.
We are.
I love it. It's nice to see that there's a pub chef actually putting out a crisp with bacon chili, making the powder out of tapioca maltodextrin.
Tapioca maltodextrin?
Yeah, which will make any fat into a powder.
I need you to touch my chip.
It's got vinegar on it.
That's because it's a vegetarian version.
I taste chili, I taste bacon. That smells like old feet.
Would you say you're a selective eater?
I'm not a selective eater. I just wasn't raised eating beef or pork. I'm a chicken turkey vegetarian.
Oh my God, how did you even say that?
That's the best thing anyone's ever said. Okay, chef, we're ready to serve.
The idea behind plating ice salad in separate components as a food should be an element of choose your own adventure. People should be able to build the flavor combinations that they want.
So this is the Hims and lemonade salad.
Amazing.
This course is the Pim's lemonade beet salad with candied pine nuts and Wesleydale cheese with cranberries.
It seems to me like she just kind of took the salad that we all know and just took the pieces apart without any kind of real strong conviction about why it should be that way.
Have you said anything about the cheese?
I love the cheese.
So much flavor, so different, so fabulous, and so edible. Excuse me.
So, and this is bone marrow and Stilton.
For the dietary restriction, I wanted to have matching flavors, so I made a caramelized onion Stilton fondue. It's like they're eating like the vegetarian version of the bone marrow.
Okay.
Ooh. This is the bone marrow.
Now this is exciting.
Bone marrow, yummy, yummy.
I got cheese and onions.
Ooh. Do you want to taste it? Your breath is going to be amazing.
I'll give you a big pen.
Really love it.
I don't know about you guys, but this plate is absolutely sublime to me. She took a perfect ingredient and presented it simply.
This speaks pup food to me.
When I tasted her signature dish, I asked her to think less and feel more, and I think we just took a break from the intellectual pursuit and exercise that she's been going through, and I'm definitely feeling something from this.
Mm-hmm. Plates are cleared.
Plates are cleared? Definitely not as tender as I wanted it to be.
I'm worried about the brisket. If there's not enough time for the meat to break down, it's actually kind of nasty, right? Because then you have like this tough meat and like these big chunks of like fat in between that, and it's just not pleasant.
What do they call Yorkshire pudding in America? Are they called topovers or something?
Popovers.
Popovers.
Yeah,
I love it.
This course is the beer braised beef brisket and Yorkshire pudding. Raven, what did you get?
I got gnocchi and the popover.
This is amazing, by the way.
Yorkshire pudding is
really
perfect.
Good. I find the beef too dry. This is very, very lean. And whereas normally...
Well, it's beef brisket. It's not supposed to be lean. Yeah. We actually had a conversation about how much she trimmed the brisket. I was very curious to know if she trimmed any of the fat at all. Mm-hmm. I don't see a reason to take off any of the fat. Just let it melt into the...
Yeah. Yeah. That gnocchi. You know what it like reminded me of? Tater tots you get from school that you have.
Yes.
That. It was a tater tot,
exactly,
man. I wanted like ketchup. It brings me joy.
Chef Janet, they're done.
They're done?
They stopped eating.
Okay.
So I'm plating my food. with all the adrenaline, you know, you definitely get a bit shaky.
Wait, not yet. Sorry.
You know, my timer's going down.
It's difficult to throw a dinner party to begin with, but then when you're putting a lot of elements on a plate in a short amount of time, it's challenging.
So if you could just pour.
Graziano's like, pouring?
Just like a tiny bit, tiny bit. Just so that you can
on
still
top
barely.
Or around?
Oh, no, around, yeah, pull around, yeah. Not that it tugged, but just a little bit, okay.
Are they ready to go?
Yes, they're ready to go.
Perfect.
Thank you.
So this is our dessert, the rose mascarpone cloud with milky tea broth.
I have no idea what British milk tea broth is, and I'm British.
This is a perfect dessert. It's light, it's delicious, it's something I've never tasted before. It's a cloud.
It's a cloud? This one you're in love with.
I'm in love with it. I might marry this one, yeah.
That's terrible for me. Really bad. Yeah, sure.
Frank, what did you think of the dessert?
It was tasty, could have been more hearty. In this new world of gastropub food, I think it was a reach, but it was adequate.
Chef, dessert is down, everything's good.
Thank you very much.
I'm proud because I feel like I really busted my ass to, you know, throw a great dinner party. My food was completely amazing out of this world.
I asked our chefs to do one thing, make sure that we have a good time. And I had a great time, and I look forward to our next dinner party. Would you like to join me there?
Yeah.
Why not?
Oh, yeah.
Life is good.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your second dinner party.
Now we are talking.
Now this is bloody England.
Oh, I like this. Yeah. This feels this like Soho House to me.
I love it.
Oh, and look at the menu over there, too.
I like it a lot.
Simple. I love the craft paper, farm table. The Chesterfield sofa.
And guys, you do not have a proper pub unless you have a cock. There we go.
All right, gentlemen. We are going to be banging out 6 courses. I'm thinking 8 minutes a course, max.
In the Marines, there's only one general, so I want the staff to understand clearly what I'm looking for.
So let's work together, man. Let's get this done.
Absolutely.
All right, man, let's pump this out.
Oh, look, so English pea soup. Oh, my God, we're having fish and chips,
like
too.
It, no.
With truffle chips. Truffles are my favorite.
They are delicious. Oh.
What a girl loves truffles,
yeah.
Bone marrow, yeah. I mean.
Lobster
all aphrodisiacs, as I might know.
For the first course, I was making the pea soup with the ham.
Should be no more than 5 minutes, bro. Holmesy.
For the dietary restriction,
I'm doing toasted cumin in tomato soup with a rye crisp.
This is what I'm all about. Solid, good comfort food coming right from the soul. And I was like, all right, let's get this over with, man. You got it. Make it happen. Right back.
And our menu tonight is English pea soup.
I'm a big, big fan of pea soup, and I've actually tried to make it myself before. I put far too much in my blender, and the whole thing went all across my kitchen.
Bloody hell.
And all over me, and it looked as though I'd murdered Kermit.
I thought the texture was great. I love the fact there were peas in the soup, and...
Imagine peas in pea soup. Raven, what did you think of your not pea soup?
I have hot salsa.
You have hot salsa? She is different. Hers
is
different.
I need you to taste it.
Here, try this, Rocco. Mm-hmm. But... All of your first courses smell funny. Did you smell this?
Yes, I smelled it.
Christopher, what did you think of the pea soup?
I really loved it. I thought it was terrific, and it wasn't too creamy. It's
probably tell us, like, by Joe.
Very good book. What, Mike?
I'm watching Kevin plating. I'm thinking, oh, this food was really simple. He could just kind of pull it out and just plop it onto the plate.
We're looking at 7 minutes. Go.
I'm using the crayons that we're given here, which is a big plus. I think that's fantastic.
Is it true that you've been in over 100 feature films?
Yes, I think someone counted the other day. And to be grateful for every gig I get. It happens you hit 50 or something years old, and they say, yeah, let's do this. And you take your clothes off, and then let's do this. 3 movies in a row, I'm taking my clothes off.
I love it.
Why didn't they hit me when I was like in 30, when I was like, oh, boom.
Might as well just keep drinking at this
point,
right?
Might as well, exactly.
So this course is the fish and chips.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
The batter's wonderful. It's light and airy, and I'm enjoying the fish.
The coleslaw also.
Not too creamy.
Really light and really fresh.
I love that I'm in London with no 18-hour flight.
It took me so long to get that pot pie right where I wanted. The velouté was perfect. And I saw some saffron, so I was like, oh, maybe I'll add a little saffron to this. I think in haste, I just kind of threw a little too much saffron in there. You know, you could smell it. It was so intense. I'm kicking myself. Why did I do that? I didn't need to do that. This is gonna cost me. That's a $20,000 pinch of saffron. Oh my God.
Let's roll with these right here, guys. I want the handle to the left, and the large cast iron skillets are gonna be warm.
Wow, the food is just like racing out of the kitchen here.
Wow. This is a lobster pot pie. When I think of pot pie, I think of Cartman, unfortunately.
That is so Raven.
Ooh, saffron.
Too much? It tastes like you're licking bathroom tile. Sorry, I didn't mean to put that in your head.
It's a powerful flavoring.
Yeah, everything else has to sort of fight its way through to your palate.
Excuse, I'm gonna go lick bathroom tile to see if it compares.
Hang on.
Let's see which one's more delicious.
Coming at you, look out, working hard.
My dishes were much simpler, comfort food, lamb and beans. Everything was flowing great. The timing was awesome.
As soon as I sauce it, you guys can roll, okay?
Go ahead, start walking.
All right.
What are we eating now, by the way?
This is the lamb tenderloin.
I've never had baked beans on lamb, ever.
My head is telling me I don't like them, but somehow I keep eating this dish. I'm not sure what it is.
I'm with Rocco. Something about the beans I enjoyed.
No, see, that for me doesn't work.
Raven, you got lamb?
I did get lamb.
So you don't eat lamb?
She gave it up.
Red meat.
We told him no pork, no beef. We didn't tell him no red meat.
I enjoyed the beans and I enjoyed the chard. I know, I forget lamb.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby, reduce down.
If your room's clear, you have 25 and a half minutes left.
25 and a half minutes, huh? You know he's gonna rip my head off if we finish early.
Well, you put more love into it.
I was barely out.
You know?
Check it out. This is for the special request.
For a Raven?
It's a edamame tomato filet and red onion salad.
Okay.
And this right here is my interpretation of liver and onions. Get me out of here.
Ooh, what's this?
This is calf's liver.
Here's the liver, guys.
Yeah.
And the onions are caramelized, so it's like so rich, like an onion soup. It's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was well done.
I know you guys had liver, but I had a wonderful edamame salad.
You loved it?
I swallowed it whole.
White dark chocolate and banana bread pudding with bruleed banana. Maybe I should have kept it a little more rustic, but you know, I kind of like the way there's the three different elements, and you know, I'm feeling good. Thank you very much.
I worked with Paula Poundstone, I worked with Julie Andrews, and all of them were just like super chill. You know, there's so many people fighting for attention. They've had that moment, and they don't need to steal it from anyone else. I'm excited.
What is this?
This white and dark chocolate bread pudding.
That's what I'm talking about. That's my chocolate and my bread pudding.
This seemed a little off the mark for me. You know, the deconstructed bread pudding. Separating it just took away everything for me.
The problem I had, the deconstruction wasn't the problem, the texture was.
I expected a proper bread and butter pudding.
Say this is your least favorite, Kat?
Yeah. For me in this room, this is my least favorite.
Is that pretty much unanimous?
This, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So were you happy with everything?
It is what it is. I hope I did enough to win, and if I don't win, I'm gonna be a little upset, but I know Janet did a great meal, but I, you know, I was so nervous. How do you know?
It's so sad that his last impression wasn't his best impression, but I mean, he did a really good job with the other courses.
And I thought it was great. It's hearty, it's rich.
Felt comforting, which I think is kind of the essence of what we're after.
So two very different dinner parties, but I get the sense that we had fun in both rooms.
Yeah.
The dinner guests proved to be the real prize of the evening, but I have to decide which chef wins.
Okay.
I'll be right back with the winner.